Rahmatullah, good evening to everyone. First of all, I would like to thank Mr. Zafar Qureshi and the Kashmir Campaign Global for organizing such a timely and important event. Actually, we do organize such annual meetings at the 5th of February as a Kashmiri Solidarity Day in Turkey. But right now, it has been a year since the Indian government unilaterally scrapped Article 370 of Indian Constitution, which ensures the special status of the Jammu and Kashmir. Actually, Jammu and Kashmir disputes remains one of the oldest disputes at the agenda of the United Nations Security Council, along with the Palestine issue, and the right to self-determination to the Kashmiris recognized by the United Nations Charter and guaranteed by United Nations Security Council resolutions, continued to be denied to the Kashmiris, and which resulting in the Gates long conflicts and one of the greatest human tragedies. Well, we do were aware that, and many participants as mentioned, and many other reports provided evidence about the grave human rights violations since the last year. Of course, there was occupation more than 70 years, but especially for the last 1 year, a prolonged lockdown and arbitrary detentions, fake encounters, and extrajudicial killings, and indiscriminate and arbitrary use of force, included pellet guns against the unarmed Kashmiri people, and continued detention of the Kashmiri political leaders is continuing for the years. And alhamdulillah, all the participants of this webinar is mentioned a lot about this issue, and I don't want to go deeper on this, but once it comes to the solutions, what we can do, of course, the conversation and negotiations comes at the first. But once we look at the Modi's governments and it is acts, because after the 5th of August, the new regulations comes from the Modi governments, such as Jammu Kashmir recognition or the organization order and Jammu and Kashmir grant the Mukhail self-case rules. It is violating all the human rights of the Kashmiris in the region. But moreover, the Modi government is now treating all Muslims in the India, such as it is regulation of CAA, which almost make the Muslims only being a Muslim enough as a criminal. So it will be like impossible to negotiate and discuss with the issues of the Kashmiris with the such government. But anyhow, for all the Muslims, we should raise our voice to make them to sit on table and to make them to compromise. So I think the OIC should have the very important role over here because not any even single Muslim country can handle this problem. So all Muslim countries should come together to raise their voices to stop this massacre what is happening right now in the Kashmir. So to make the Muslim countries' governments to come together for such important issue, all the publics of the Muslim countries is responsible to raise the public awareness about the issue. Just a moment, Mr. Enes is underlined that the many publics, especially in the countries of Muslim countries, they do not very much aware what is happening right now in the Kashmir. So all the NGOs, especially they are responsible to raise the awareness about the massacres and what is happening in the Kashmir right now. And it can happen in many ways, as underlined, the social media is very important tool for us right now, because the many the media outlets, other outlets is not very favoring these issues, but the social media, especially nowadays, is very important tool for the awareness of the public opinion. Besides that, the lobbying is in our countries, in our political arenas is very important, and NGOs over here can play a vital role to do that. Especially here in the Turkey, we doing such things because we are organizing annual meetings for to raise the awareness about the Kashmiri, and we are publishing the public outlets, and especially we are having a special newsletters for the issue of the Kashmir. Of course, it is not enough. We should come together with their activities, and we should struggle against this massacre in the Kashmir. I don't want to be so long because it is quite a bit late now here in the Turkey as well. And I'd like to thank again Mr. Zafer Qureshi and the Kashmir Campaign Global to having us here today. And I do believe that me personally get benefited a lot what I heard here from all the participants in this webinar. Thank you very much and good evening to everyone.